These were being registered by the M23 authorities, but children and old people were allowed to move without prior registration. M23 spokesman Willy Ngoma condemned the increasing levels of sectarianism in the DRC authorities.
Oh yeah, apa Bunagana.
We always say that our enemy is FADAC. They gang up and attack our positions.
Chanzu, Runyoni, Mabomi,
we retaliate. We only want to sit together and hold talks.
We are
allowing our brothers and sisters to return home because it is safe and we want them to return to business. We push the enemies far and now children can return to school. The RDC of Kisoro Shafik Sekandi welcomed the decision by M23 to allow locals to return home. Today, over 100 refugees were seen lining up for clearance to return home, but other refugees were seen camped on the Ugandan side, still undecided on their next course of action.
It's our prayer that the fighting groups sit with the government of Congo and talk peace, and then have people received back home, and they enjoy the peace of their country and they develop. I want to send my message of appreciation to the donor partners for the support, but I'm also giving a message of consolation to the refugees that don't lose heart. We are with you, we are standing with you, and I want you to know it that Uganda is not in this war as some people have been alleging. And the refugees are aware that Ugandans are hospitable people. The host communities have been very positive. They share with the refugees water.
Meanwhile, there is tension in Kisoro district following the increasing cases of COVID-19 among the refugee community currently staying at Nyakabande Refugee Holding Center. Haj Shafik Sekandi, the Kisoro Resident District Commissioner, says the holding center has 116 cases of COVID-19 in isolation and they cannot accommodate the growing numbers in the isolation center. 221 cases of COVID-19 have been registered at the holding center since 28th March 2022.
Because of the increase in the number of the people who are tested positive, all those people are removed from the tents of others and they are put into isolation. The numbers are increasing very fast and the space is not enough because we want people to isolate, social distance, and then they undergo treatment. So the isolation space is not enough.
Philippe San Crepi, the Assistant Representative Operations for United Nations High Commission for Refugees, said that the existing COVID-19 risk is challenging for them to transport asylum seekers to various settlements.
We have 7,000 already relocated in Naki Valley, 290 kilometers from Kisoro, 6 hours with the buses. It means what? You need more support for the people here because we have Kisoro or the center, Transit Center, and on the right hand, Naki Valley. Also, you need support on both sides in terms of wash, more water tank, in terms of shelter, accommodation, because the situation in DRC, as you know, it is not stable, it's very fragile. And you need more also core relief items, CRI. I'm talking about blanket, plastic sheeting, and jerry can, more and more.
Report by Job Namanya and Kate Atuzarire for the news in Kisoro.